Sometimes there are obstacles in the road that can leave you feeling low, and you don't know how to move forward. And sometimes there are turns you wanna take, but the way gets hard to trace. Now you're wondering, how did you get here? But don't you give up until you see how God is ordering your steps, so you can walk into your season. He that has begun a great work in you is faithful to perform. God is faithful to perform. He that has begun a great work in you is faithful to perform. Our God is faithful. The Lord and receive a harvest for your seed, and in due time God will blow your mind with what he planted inside of you to bless the world as it blooms. A great work. It's faithful to perform. God is faithful to perform. Oh, he that has begun a great work in you is faithful to perform it. God is faithful to perform it. So if you ever get discouraged, speak to yourself and say, God is doing a great work. He's doing a great work. He's doing a great work in me. God is doing a great work. He's doing a great work. He's doing a great work. Jesse. God is doing a great work. He's doing a great work. Doing a great work. God is doing a great work. Yes, he is. Begun a great work in you is faithful to perform. God is faithful to perform. If you got it right here, encourage your neighbor. A great work is faithful to perform it. God is faithful to perform it. Yesterday, today, and forevermore. God is faithful.
He's faithful to
faithful
perform.
And great.
He's faithful to perform.
Great is his faithfulness. Great is his faithfulness.
God is doing a great work.
And what should be considered as we proceed is that this work did not begin with you. Our mothers' mothers and fathers' fathers planted seeds when we were but the faint notion of a dream in their mind. They hope for a harvest, a legacy, a great work. So make your next step forward. Help us to connect the dots and see this. picture of greatness. In fact, I hear God say that you are His workmanship, His masterpiece, created for such a time as this, for great works, a great, great, great works. So God needs works. Don't get discouraged. God is doing a great work. He's doing a great work in me. God is doing over and over and over and over and over. He's doing a great work. God is doing a great work. Doing a great work, He's doing a great work in me. God is doing a great work, He's doing a great work, He's doing a great work in me.
Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Oh, we bless you this morning, Father. We're so grateful. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. We just say thank you this morning. He who has begun a good work in us. Father, we thank you that you will bring it to completion. Hallelujah. We're so grateful this morning. Thank you for this brand new day, Father. We're grateful. As we come to you this morning, we say thank you for the breath in our lungs. Thank you for strengthening our bodies today, Father. We lift our hearts to you this morning with gratitude and praise. Hallelujah. We're grateful for the rest that you've provided for us, Father, last night, and we're rejuvenating our bodies this morning and in our minds. For this day, for this is the day that you've made, Father. We're rejoicing. We're glad in it. And Father, we give this day back to you this morning. We say thank you. Thank you for bringing us into this brand new day. We are truly grateful today, Father. Thank you for the peaceful sleep that you that allowed us to wake up this morning refreshed, renewed, and ready for this new day. We are so grateful, Father, for your protection. We thank you this morning. Hallelujah. Oh, we're grateful this morning, Father. It's just, our hearts are just overwhelmed this morning with just gratitude this morning. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for humble hearts this morning, seeking your presence, your guidance. And we acknowledge your sovereignty this morning. You are God. You are Lord of all. Thank you for the great work you are doing in our lives today, Lord. And so, Father, we thank you, for we know that our latter shall be greater than our former. And so let us not just get stuck on what's already been done. but knowing today that you're doing a great work in us. Despite the trials and the tribulations, despite all the things we've gone through, Father, we still trust your plan and your purpose for our lives today. That's what your word says in Philippians 1 and 6, Father, says it reassures us that he who begun a good work, he who began a good work in us will carry it on to completion until the day of Jesus Christ. So this morning, Father, we identify this promise and we cling to this promise, knowing that you're always working for our good, Lord, even when we cannot see it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father, this morning. We're so grateful today, Father, as we identify this promise. And not only that, Father, but we get to see it as already done. We thank you that you are doing a great work in us. And so we're grateful right now for a new mindset on this Friday morning. Thank you for renewing our minds and helping us to focus on what is true, what is noble, what is right, what is pure, what is lovely, and what is admirable. As we think of Philippians 4 and verse 8 there, Father, we thank you. Thank you for filling our thoughts with your truth and wisdom today. So even right now, we cast down every thought, every negative thought. Every negative thought, we cast it down now. Any doubts or fears that may be trying to take root today, Father, we cast it out in the name of Jesus. We cast it aside now in the mighty name of Jesus. Negative thoughts, doubts, fears. And instead, right now, Father, may we be filled with your peace. And we thank you that we're thinking intentionally on things that are true, noble, right, pure, lovely. And admirable. And so we thank you for that today. Thank you for your peace, Father, that surpasses all understanding. We're so grateful today that we can rest in you, Father. We can truly give you glory and honor right now, Father, in the name of Jesus. We thank you. And we praise you as your vessels today, Father. We're so grateful for what you're doing in our lives. We don't take it for granted. We say thank you, Lord, for you are doing a great work in us today. Thank you, Father, for your protection. Thank you as we go about today that you're keeping us, you're guarding us from harm and danger. We thank you. Thank you for keeping us safe under the shadow of your wings, Father. As we think of your word this morning, Psalm 91 and verse 4 reminds us that you will cover us with your feathers. And under your wings, we will find refuge. Your faithfulness will be our shield and our rampart. And so we stand on this promise today. And confidence that you are our protector and our stronghold. We thank you this morning. Hallelujah. We're so grateful this morning, Father. We praise you. Thank you, Lord. And we give you glory today. And as you're doing a great work in our lives, Father, we're so grateful that we're truly able to be encouraged today, knowing this. Thank you for encouragement, endurance. In the midst of it all, Father, in the midst of the life challenges and We know it's easy to get weary and lose heart, Father, but your word tells us today. In Galatians 6 and 9 tells us to not become weary in doing good. For at the right time, at the proper time, we will reap a harvest if we do not give up. So this morning, Father, we're asking you to strengthen our resolve. Strengthen our resolve, Father. Help us to persevere in faith this morning. And continue to do good. Help us, Father, even when the path is difficult. Remind us that you're always with us, Father, and that you will never leave us. Hallelujah. And you will never forsake us. Your presence is our constant source of comfort and strength. And when we feel alone, may we remember that you are our ever-present help in times of trouble. When we feel weak, may we draw strength from you, Lord. When we feel discouraged, may your promises uplift us, Father, that we're able to identify a promise that tells us to be not dismayed. For I am with you always. So this morning, Father, we thank you for the people that you have placed in our lives. Thank you for the ones who encourage us, who speak life into us, who build us up, who speak truth. Thank you for our family, Father, our friends, our colleagues. Thank you, Father, for all those who support and encourage us. And so, Father, help us to be a source of encouragement to them as well. Don't let us just be receivers, but let us be givers. Let us be the one who encouraged someone. So may our words and our actions reflect your love and grace, Father. Use us as to uplift and inspire others, pointing them to your goodness and your faithfulness. And so this morning, Father, we ask you today to guide us in all that we do on this Friday morning. We ask that you would lead us by your Holy Spirit today, Father. Lead us. Help us to walk in obedience to your will today. Grant us wisdom in our decisions, courage in our actions today, Father, and love today, Father, in our interactions. So may everything we do today bring glory to your name, Father. And we surrender this day back to you, Lord, trusting that you are in control. We release every worry, every ounce of anxiety. We release it and cast it into your hands right now in the name of Jesus. We release it now, knowing that you care for us deeply, Father. And so your word tells us in 1 Peter 5 and 7, cast all our cares, our anxieties on you because you care for us. And so this morning, Father, we take comfort in knowing that you are concerned with every detail of our lives, every aspect. And we thank you for that today, Father. We thank you that there's nothing too small or too big that you cannot handle, that we cannot cast it on you, Father. And so let us be mindful that we don't worry, that we're not anxious, but we can cast those cares upon you, Father. And so this morning we lay up at your feet today, knowing that you are faithful, Father. Thank you for your faithfulness, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you for your faithfulness this morning. Hallelujah. And we praise you today, Father. We give you glory. So we thank you, Father, for your love. And we thank you for the assurances that your word give us. And so, Father, we just want to give you glory in every season. We want to give you praise in every season, give you honor in every season of our lives. We know you remain faithful. You are constant. And you are unchanging. Hallelujah. In every season, you're faithful, Father. Hallelujah. Your promises are yes and amen. And we thank you for that. And we praise your name, Father. Hallelujah. We give you glory, God, even right now as your children. Let us run with perseverance. This journey requires us to persevere in faith. Run with perseverance. The race marked out for us. It's not a sprint, but a marathon. And it requires endurance. It requires patience and faith. And so in moments when we feel like giving up, we can draw strength from you, Lord, and knowing that you equip us with everything we need to keep moving forward. And that you are doing a great work. Hallelujah. So sometimes it feels like it's not moving, it's not progressing, like I'm going backwards. But today, Father, we thank you that we know that you are doing a great work in our life. And Father, we thank you that you designed us to live in community. We're so grateful this morning for this community, Father. Love what your word says in Ecclesiastes 4:9. Two are better than one because they have a good return for their labor. If either of them fails or falls down, one can help the other up. We're clear that we are not meant to navigate life's challenges alone. And so, Father, we thank you for placing people in our lives to support and encourage and uplift us today. Let us not forget the power of community. And we thank you for that today. And so, Father, let us have an attitude of gratitude today for the ones you've placed around us, who text us, who call, who speak to us, who pray with us, who pray over us. We thank you for that today. And we praise your name. Never let us take it for granted, but give you glory. So we praise you, Father, as we go out today as your ambassadors. Let us go in the spirit of humility, the spirit of love. And so today we come against the spirit of pride and rebellion. But let us operate in the spirit of obedience. And we thank you for that today, Father. We thank you for giving us what we need for this day. And we say thank you. We don't take it for granted. We're truly grateful that you're moving and you're working. That's comforting, Father. We thank you. So let us go with your flow today. For it's in you that we live, move, and have our being. And we give you all the glory today, Father. Thank you for delivering us. Thank you for healing us. Thank you, Father, for the freedom we have in Christ Jesus. Thank you that we're not bound by the things of this world. We're not bound by sin and not bound by death. Thank you for eternal life today. Hallelujah, Lord. We're so grateful that we live from a place of victory because of Christ. And we praise you today. And we say, Lord, have your way. For you know the plans that you have for us. Plans to prosper us and not to harm us. Plans to give us a hope and a future. Your plans for us are good, Father, and we thank you. And they're filled with hope. And so even when we encounter detours, this wasn't what I expected. This wasn't my plan. Even when we encounter detours and setbacks, we can trust that, Father, you are weaving all things together. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are weaving it together for our good. And we praise you today. And we give you glory and honor. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Thank you for the right perspective today. Thank you for good health. Thank you for prospering us. Thank you for good health today, even as our soul prospers. This is a promise. This is what you desire for us. And we praise your name today. And we give you all the glory. Have your way in our lives. We say thank you, Lord. This day is committed to you. We love you, Lord, and we say thank you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. To God be the glory. Hallelujah.